Projector settings is where you can set up the settings of a specific piece of output hardware, like an FP3 or FP4. You can control things like its scan rate and color. It is located under Settings, Projector Settings. This window is the same in QuickShow and beyond and share the same functions. On the left, we have a list of connected hardware. Simply select them to start adjusting their settings. To preview our changes, we can use the Test Patterns window to enable output to see our changes live. First, we have size and position. Use size and position to give a global change in limitations of a projector. This can be useful if you have two different projectors from two different manufacturers and would like to try and match them to each other. The average user keeps everything at default but makes the projection size 100-100, making all adjustments in the projection zones instead. Under scan rate, we can adjust how fast our laser scanners and laser modulation occur. We can set our default points per second, industry standard being 30,000. And change our minimum and maximum depending on our comfort level on overdriving our scanners using effects. We can also change the color shift, which can adjust delays and timing of color data compared to scanner data. If you're seeing tails or what appear to be mistimed laser data, use this. The average projector works on color shift 4, but you may need to tweak if you're experiencing tails on your projectors. Under color settings, you can select what type of color projector you have and then decide if it's TTL, analog with linear response, or if you'd like log response for more contrast and lower output levels. Then, below you can adjust your colors to color balance projectors together using your max and minimum output. If you'd like more color balance control, you can select advanced in the projector type selection. We cover this in a deep dive video. Under vector display settings, we can change how the projector calculates blanking and anchors. In most cases, the default setting should work. But if you experience tails or unusual performance of your projector in terms of the start of lines and the end of lines, you may need to adjust these settings to get the best output from your projector. Under information, you can give your output hardware a name to easily remember it and see any feedback on hardware and its functions. There may also be extra windows, like FP4 DMX Serial Out or FP4 Controlled Digra Motors, but these are discussed in separate videos related to those specific features. Thank you for watching our Quick Hints video on projector settings. If you still need support, you can contact our support line. Or, if you have time, you can watch our deep dive video on global settings. Thank you for watching.